Hi, guys. Keep your eyes on the road. Watch Mrs. Scudera as she lets it roll.
First, get on, boys and girls.
Turn the key just like you would a vehicle.
Okay, I'm gonna turn the key to start it next.
Good. Okay. Now, right here, you see H for high. You see the H?
Okay, I see the H.
And
okay.
Look where you're at right here. High.
High, okay.
Low, look low.
Okay, low, yes.
Okay, neutral. Right there, you see the N.
So that's the
neutral
between the high and the low.
No, neutrals, high, low, neutral.
Oh, okay. Okay, high, low, neutral. Okay.
Then reverse. Right there, lift R.
R, okay.
Everything's here. Now, okay. Put your foot down on, this is your back brake.
Okay.
Put it down.
All right.
Yep. Now, you're in park.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so.
All right.
You
gotta
go back up though. Okay, reverse, neutral. Okay, now put it high.
Okay, good. Can you take my brake off though?
Yeah, you can take
okay,
it.
Take my brake off. High.
Yep, that's
okay.
Low. Look at your low.
Low. Oh, I see low. Okay, one more is high.
Okay, now put your brake down. Put your brake down.
Okay.
Just like a clutch. Now put it in high.
Oh, it is? Just like a clutch. Okay, all right.
Good. Now
okay.
You're in high. Now you're ready to go.
So, do I let the brake off easy?
No, just let it go.
Okay, let the brake off. And then the next thing, after that, what do I do?
Press the throttle.
Throttle, okay.
And you steer.
And then I can see. Oh, my helmet, and then boys and girls, for safety, we must put a helmet on. First, Jeff, take your glasses. All right. My new toy, boys and girls. And this is my son, Micah, and his girlfriend, Taylor, videoing.
Mrs. Ehlers is shining bright. She is going to show you how to plant an onion just right.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
Hi, boys and girls. This is Mrs. Ehlers, and I'm going to show you today a how-to lesson on planting an onion plant. The first thing you need to do is work the garden with your garden claw. So I'm working the dirt, and I'm loosening it up, boys and girls, so that it's all ready for the smooth it over a little bit and use the handle part to make a hole. And I have four plants, so I'll make four holes. Then I'll take my plant, my onion plant, and stick one in each hole. Packing the dirt in around the plant. finally, I'll take my hose and I'll squirt a little water on them, kind of spray them so they kind of get wet and loosen up and get a good drink of water. Boys and girls, this is how you plant an onion plant. Thanks. Bye.
Baby, get ready to fish up some fun with Mrs. McConkie on how to build a dirt worm cup.
Hi, first graders. It's Mrs. McConkie. I sure miss you right now, and I wish we were back in our classroom. But since we can't be, I'm going to share another one of my favorite places. And it's here at home in my very own kitchen. One of the things I've been doing a lot of is baking. A lot with my boys, but sometimes even by myself here at home. Today I'd like to share a simple recipe with you in the how-to format that you'll be working on and writing. First graders, after I've washed my hands, the first thing I'm going to want to do before I begin starting my dirt cups is to assemble all the ingredients. I need milk, I need vanilla and chocolate pudding, I need Cool Whip or whipped topping, I need Oreos or chocolate sandwich cookies, and last but not least, every kid's favorite ingredient, gummy worms. First, you take a jar or a cup, and you're going to sprinkle some chocolate sandwich cookies in the bottom. I made my cookies into crumbs by using my food processor, but you could use a baggie and a rolling pin or a blender at your house also. Next, I take some of the pudding that I created from the instant pudding, the milk, and the Cool Whip, and I place it on top of those cookie crumbs. Then I'm going to do the favorite step of most first graders. I'm going to take my bag of gummy worms and I'm going to put some gummy worms into the pudding next, being careful to hide them from the sides of the jar so nobody knows they're there except us. Once I've got those gummy worms in my jar, it's time to hide them. So next, I'm going to take more cookie crumbs, sprinkle them on top. Then I'll add another layer of delicious chocolate pudding. I'll add a couple more worms. I'll take another layer of chocolate cookies. And finally, I'm going to take one of Mom's craft flowers and I'm going to place it right on top. First graders, this dirt cup looks good enough to eat. All you need is a spoon and your appetite.
Oh, by the way, we have your good friend Mr. Gray ready to share a picture on this fine day.
Jeremiah was a bullfrog, was a good friend of mine.
Hi boys and girls, it's Mr. Gray and today I'm going to show you how to draw a cartoon frog. Are you ready to follow along? You'll need paper and a marker. Let's get started. Frogs begin life as a tadpole and then undergo metamorphosis to become a frog. First, we will begin our frog by drawing a circle for the head. Draw the body as an oval below the head. Frogs have powerful legs that allow them to hop great distances. Next, draw the frog's legs as curved lines that move away from the body. Draw the frog's feet that look like lowercase m's. A frog's feet are like flippers that allow them to swim fast. Then draw the frog's front legs that are two sets of straight lines that get smaller at the bottom. Add the frog's front feet by drawing lowercase m's like you did earlier. Finally, a frog's eyes are bigger compared to its head. Draw two eyes that are two big circles. Once you are done, you can add a lily pad, flies, and any other details you'd like. I hope you all enjoyed this how-to. Your teachers would love to see your creations. We miss you all. Bye for now.